What's up, everybody? On today's episode of Digital Marketing Duels, we're going to have two marketing experts debate influencer marketing versus Facebook ads. My name is Connor McDaniel, and I'm going to be your host. Are you on the side of influencer marketing with Anna Kalile or on the side of Facebook ads with Stephen Page? The rules are simple. This is a debate. Each opponent will be given the opportunity to introduce themselves, their main point, and a rebuttal against their opponent's argument.
Let the fight begin!
All right, let me just drop some facts for you. Influencer marketing is the way to go. Facebook ads, are you kidding me? What, are we dinosaurs? Oh, no, no, no. Influencer marketing is so impactful. It is the future of marketing. You know why? Because they actually have built-in buyer personas in their audience, and they're already nurtured leads. They're warm, they're ready to convert. So if you actually partner with an influencer as a brand, you can have them convert faster than if you have to nurture them with tons and tons of ads. Everybody's sick of ads.
Ooh, shots fired. This gonna be good.
That's a good point. If you could track and measure influencer marketing, with Facebook ads, you can run ads, retarget, and scale campaigns. You could spend thousands of dollars a day on advertising in a targeted manner and reach the right audience at the right time and retarget them as well effectively.
Touche.
What do you mean you can't track influencer marketing? Are you kidding me? Yeah, if you're not doing it right.
Oof.
Influencer marketing is easily trackable if you have affiliate codes. So for example, if you put a code attached to their name, then you can actually track which sales are coming from which influencers, and you can actually feed more money into that influencer, into that account, into that audience. So yes, you can track, and especially if you know how to actually market, you're gonna send them different Bitly links, different URLs, so that you can actually do the tracking internally. So that's how you actually maximize working with influencers and know what actually works.
Whoa, Annika, how are you gonna beat that, Steven?
So you're gonna trust the general public to remember a link, remember an affiliate code, somehow navigate your profile to find this link to your offer? Good luck.
Ooh.
Yeah, no luck needed for this one.
Wow.
We actually know that we can promote our link and our code over and over and over again. You know why? Because we can actually give influencers commission. So they're gonna promote it over and over and over again. So if they actually have an incentive to promote it every day, every week, and keep feeding that code, the audience is actually gonna remember that code, and they're actually going to convert and purchase that product. It just makes sense. And honestly, we have to think about marketing trends. Where is marketing going? Marketing is leading toward authenticity. We want to make sure that we are authentic. So influencers represent that authenticity because they're real people, real humans, and they're sharing their real lives. So that is really, really impactful. And yeah, they have influence with their audience. They're the modern day celebrities, and it's so important for brands to be able to partner with an influencer that fits with their brand.
That was on point.
You're talking about their audience, but you're not gonna be able to reach the majority of the audience, or you're gonna tap it out. Then you're gonna have to find another influencer to somehow reach the same audience with the same age range and the same interests, where in Facebook ads, you can find that audience, you can find their interests, demographics, financial behaviors, things like that, and target them, and then increase your audience and scale your budget to the moon if you want to.
How are you gonna recover from that one, Annika?
Yeah, but I argue, how effective are those ads? Do you know how many people just scroll past ads? Like, they just don't even recognize it anymore. They just are so done with ads. They're so tired, exhausted, fatigued from this spam content from brands. So actually working with an influencer is way more realistic. And if we talk about tapping out of an audience, debatable, because there's tons of influencers around the world if you really wanted to get that macro with it. Yeah, you can't really run out of influencers. Do you know how many thousands and thousands and thousands of fitness influencers? Yes, there are tons of influencers for each niche. And it's also cool if you can get different influencers that specializes in a few different niches, so you can test different audiences and see who's actually willing to buy your product.
Great point.
Yeah, and you're relying on these influencers to sell your product. They have to be genuine. They have to actually know your product and all the pain points that you have to sell it. And will it be effective? And it's a huge gamble. They make you spend almost sometimes thousands of dollars just to hopefully get some sales. Whereas we can, in Facebook ads, you could start small and increase your budget gradually over time instead of taking this huge chunk of money for an influencer and hoping it gets sales.
Very on point, Steven.
Honestly, you can't fly blind with an influencer, and we all know that. If we've actually done influencer marketing the right way, you know you have to do your digging. You have to do your research. You have to ask them for their insights. You have to actually get all of the data behind the account before you just hand over a ton of money. But I think it's very clear that no matter what, we can agree that both strategies are crucial in your marketing campaign. You need to have both Facebook ads and influencer marketing to run an effective campaign that is comprehensive and impactful.
Who do you think won the debate? Comment below to let us know your thoughts. Make sure to like and subscribe for more content. I'll see you next time.